Let's harness Sure for tuning the parameter T in the thresholding algorithm we presented earlier, just to see how effective this technique could be. We come back to our algorithm, and therefore the denoiser is given by D times the thresholding operator operating on D transpose times Z. We aim to set the scalar T automatically, and as we are about to see, this is definitely doable. This is a good time to mention that Sure is valid only for Gaussian noise and relevant as an effective method only when trying to set few parameters. Why? Because when only few parameters are needed, the expectation we conveniently removed remains a valid approximation. The thresholding operator is not differentiable, and thus the first thing to do is to smooth it out somehow. Here is our proposed smooth curve, which uses an even k power. When k is big enough, we get closer and closer to the ideal thresholding. Here is the derivative of this expression with respect to its input. We will need this shortly when using Sure. Let's rewrite the denoiser expression so that instead of spatially varying thresholds, we pre-multiply by the inverse of W and post-multiply by W, and in between apply a fixed threshold. Here, capital W is the diagonal matrix holding the atom norms on its main diagonal. Now we are ready to invoke Sure. Oh my god, this looks so ugly, but don't be alarmed. These are exactly the three terms we have seen when deriving Sure. The last one may be a bit more of a challenge since we need to take the derivative of the denoiser with respect to its input. In this case, the inverse of W times D transpose pops to the right and the thresholding curve is replaced by its derivative. The last term is the most complicated and we can simplify it. The steps taken here rely on properties of the trace operator. First, we move D from the left to the right. Then we observe that all the right part is some sort of a diagonal matrix and thus W and its inverse cancel out. The last step is to notice that since this is a diagonal matrix, D transpose times D can be replaced by its diagonal, which is nothing but the square of W. And this is the bottom line. All we need to do is to evaluate this expression for varying values of T and choose the one that gives the smallest estimated value. What do you think? Will it work? Works like a charm. What you see here is the original performance curve in terms of peak SNR as a function of T. On top of this curve, the dots are the Sure values. Observe that we have cheated here a little bit and added a constant so that the two curves are aligned. This has no consequence on the evaluation of T, but it looks great on the graph. So yes, there is a perfect alignment, and we could get exactly the T that gives the best performance.